Hello everybody, my name is Walter, and today I want to show you how you can build a 2x2 and a 3x3 collapsing tunnel trap, which are traps that can suffocate any tall mobs and of course players. So let's start with a little demonstration. So let's spawn a few creepers here, and just by clicking this lever, come on, as you can see, the tunnel collapses and all of those creepers now are suffocating. So this is the 2x2 version. Now let's go and show the 3x3 tunnel. And as you can see, it looks too quite nice. And as a little bonus, those traps can be as long as you want. You will just have to repeat the signal every 15 blocks or so. And if you do so, well, then the tunnels can be as long as you want them to be or need them to be. Okay, so much for the demonstration. Now for the space requirements. As you can see, the 2x2 tunnel trap only has some redstone on top of it, which means that basically the whole thing is only 2 blocks wide. The length of it is depending on how you want it to build. And the height, well, as you can see, it is only 2 blocks above the whole ceiling, which means that this is rather compact. The 3x3, as you can see here, has pistons all around, which means that it goes 3 blocks below the floor, 2 blocks above the ceiling, and 2 blocks to each side, which means that it is in total about 9 blocks high and 7 blocks wide. Again, it's as long as you want it to be. So now for the resources you will need. Of course, you will need some kind of building block. Then for the 2x2 version, you will need for every meter of length, or every block of length, you will need 1 redstone dust and 2 sticky pistons. And every 15 blocks, you will need a redstone repeater to repeat the signal, as I already mentioned. For the 3x3 tunnel, you will need 9 redstone dust, 4 redstone torches, and 2 repeaters. And then for every meter of tunnel, you will need 4 additional redstone dust, 1 additional repeater, and 4 sticky pistons. And again, to repeat the signal every 15 blocks, you will need 4 repeaters every 15 blocks. Okay, so that is how much space you need, what those things do, and of course what resources you will need. So let's start with the actual building. Okay, so let's start with the 2x2 collapsing tunnel trap. So, as you can see, I already filled in the walls and the floor. Now for the ceiling, just go 2 blocks higher than the wall and place your sticky pistons facing downwards, like this. Then fill in this whole ceiling area until you're at the end of your tunnel, just like this, and then fill in the ceiling with normal blocks. Make sure they aren't transparent blocks, since you want to suffocate your victims, and this only works with normal blocks. Okay, now to connect or to power those pistons, just run a line of normal blocks on top of one of those 2 piston lines here, and then put some redstone dust on top of those. And now all you have to do is power this redstone line, and your tunnel collapses and suffocates every player and tall mob that is inside of it. Okay, So, now if you want to use this for a tunnel that's longer than 50 blocks, you will have to repeat this power here. And for this, all you have to do is, let's say the power stops at this block here. All you have to do is go one block further, place a repeater here, then place a normal block here and some redstone on top of it. So that also that this piston here gets powered too. Okay. And as you can see, everything works just fine. And you can repeat this process as long as you want, so you can in theory have a tunnel that's infinitely long and still collapses for the full length of it. Okay. So now for the 3x3 tunnel trap. For this, start at the center of your floor and start placing upwards facing sticky pistons like this. Come on. And then normal blocks on top of those. Of course you can use transparent blocks here too. The only blocks that should be normal are the blocks on the sides and at the ceiling. And now just repeat this process on the sides of it. Come on. And at the top. Like this. Okay, now it's time to start connecting those pistons. For this, let's start down here and place a 2-wide platform just diagonally to those pistons here. Then grab your repeaters and put them down like this, directly facing into those pistons here. Make sure they are all in the default setting. Then run a line of redstone in front of those repeaters. On the first repeater, place a block just behind the repeater and then two below. Remove this block here and put a repeater on 3 ticks facing into this block here. And finally, don't forget to put a redstone dust on top of this block. Okay. Now, put a block behind this repeater on the 3 ticks. Like this. And put some redstone on top of this block. Now, some redstone on top of, as a normal block on top of the redstone to cut off this line here. Then a block on the side of this redstone with a torch on top. Then on top of the torch, a normal block. Then a torch on top of this block and finally another block on top. Now run a line of blocks on top of these pistons here on the side. And some redstone on top of those blocks. Like this. Now to the other side here. Just run a line of blocks to this side here until you are at the same Y or X coordinate like as these pistons here. So then put a block up here, redstone torch on top, block on top, torch on top, block on top. Don't worry about those blocks, they will be retracted once you connect it all up. Then again run a line of normal blocks on top of those pistons here. And again some redstone on top of those blocks. Like this. Now for the last line, just run a line of normal blocks on the side of those pistons. Redstone on top of those blocks. Like this. Then put two blocks like this and another and a third up like this. Redstone repeater on 4 ticks and find 2 redstone lines like this. And we are pretty much done. The line to power now is just down here, and as you can see, it's perfectly. Now if you want to relocate this a bit, you can, for example, just line it like this, and now we have our lever here. Okay. And we are done. Now if you want to use this for more than 15 blocks length, we have yet again to use some repeaters to repeat the signal. For this, just go to the, let's say, the redstone, the last redstone that's powered is this one here. Then remove the last one that's powered, put it down here, a repeater running in this direction, and finally place two blocks like this. Just mirror this on the other side. So here's the last block that would be powered. Redstone to this side, redstone repeater here, and another block here. The same thing on top of this one here. So remove this here, replace it with a block. Come on. Repeater. And we're done. So now last thing is down here. Again, make sure that you replace or remove the redstone just where the repeaters are on the other three piston rows. Place a block on top, then below, block here, remove this block in the middle, place some redstone on top of this block, and finally in the gap here, a redstone repeater in this direction, like this. And as you can see, it works perfectly. Okay. Okay. So that is how you can build a 2x2 and a 3x3 collapsing tunnel trap. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and, well, see ya!